Nail care often differs between men and women, but the bottom line is that our nails grow and they need to be managed. Tens of thousands of years ago, people still had fast-growing nails, but without modern tools, how did they keep their fingers looking fresh? Before going too far back in time, let's look at the nail clippers we currently have. Today, there are a few obvious options. Nail clippers typically come in two forms, pliers or compound lever. As the name pliers suggests, this small stainless steel tool looks like a set of pliers, with two metal levers connected at a fulcrum to create a set of jaws that can be precisely placed over a nail to trim it. The compound lever type is more common, with a manipulable lever that can be rotated into place with a concave clipping end. Both types are highly effective, but they've only been around since the 20th century. More rudimentary tools had emerged in the late 1870s, but before that, the history of this grooming tool is unclear. There are various literary references to people cutting their nails throughout history, but the tool of choice is almost always a small penknife or blade. Depending on social status, cultural tradition, and point in history, carrying a knife may have been very common, so the popular use of this tool makes sense. Going back even further, references to nails being cut date back to the 8th century BC, meaning this has been a point of concern for humans for at least 3,000 years. But what about even further back? Before humans developed blades or social expectations of hygiene, how did we handle the inexorably growing nails at the end of our fingers? Quite simply, fingernails probably took care of themselves. Fingernails are largely made of keratin, a hardened protein also found in skin and hair. While keratin is hardy and durable, it is far from unbreakable, as any woman with a chipped nail will attest. 100,000 years ago, early humans were hunters and gatherers, so in a given day, they might have dug tubers out of the earth, sharpened a rudimentary spear, harried makeshift shelters, or tried to start a fire. With all this manual labor, it is believed that the fingernails would have naturally worn down and chipped away. Their daily demands for survival would have kept the fingernails managed. We see this passive maintenance in other species, such as dogs, which often walk on pavement and gradually wears down their nails. If the fingernails of these early humans did break or chip, they likely solved the problem as we do today, biting or tugging off the occasional irritating hangnail. Again, we see the same behavior in other species that lick at, soften, and bite their nails when they grow too long. Everyone has their own personal preferences regarding grooming, but the practice itself dates back throughout evolutionary history. There is no denying that grooming is an essential part of our nature. Grooming is a hygienic practice that dates back millions of years and has cultural significance and social foundations. So if you're often worried about the conditions of your nails, don't worry, it's perfectly natural.